Hi everyone, I'm Andrew Carruthers, Education Director for Sambia. I want to share with you a haircut we developed called the Layla haircut. This is from our Modern Heritage collection, which is an educational collection that we really built off of the concept of honoring our heritage as hairdressers. So this is coming from 60s, 70s, 80s, all the way into the 90s. We're taking the elements we loved from those time periods and placing them into more of a modern spin. The other thing we want to make sure that happens with these haircuts is it's something simple and approachable so that you can use it immediately behind the chair. Let's get into the sectioning on the Layla haircut. This is a really cool sectioning pattern, and it's based off of a tilted line. So the first line that you're going to create is actually going to come off of the recession area. We're going to bring the line from the recession, a rounded diagonal back line that comes into this corner back. Now the way you find that corner back is you find that flatter area just behind the ear, the flatter area coming off the center back, and you find that corner, that transition from front to back. That's your corner back. So you create that curved diagonal back to that area. Go ahead and pin up the hair. On the opposite side, the tilt comes from this area being lower on the head. So now we're going to come more from the bottom of that recession area, kind of the temple area here. And again, a rounded diagonal back line that comes back to that corner back area. Once you have those two lines established, that's going to help set up everything else. If you look from the top view here, you'll come from the high point of the head and you're going to connect around to those points that you created at this corner back. From there, you continue that round all the way into the center back. So as we turn this around, you'll see that circular line comes around and down into the center back, just at the low point of the occipital. So that gives you this little yarmulke almost on the back of her head. And you'll notice from the top, we have an asymmetry, a tilt towards this left side of her head, with the parting as well. So that parting is gonna sit right over the left eye. So this entire haircut is gonna be achieved simply through razor. So we're going to use first our straight blade on our razor. And what this is gonna do is allow me to move through the shape very quickly, very evenly. Nice thing is we do have a guard on our straight blade, so I'm not worried about chomping into my fingers. We're gonna begin by taking a diagonal back section, about an inch in thickness. Comb the hair cleanly back and out of the way. And we're gonna make sure that the hair stays damp. One of the things when using a razor is we wanna make sure that there's moisture in the hair. It's gonna allow the razor to glide through the hair much easier and keep control. The other thing that we did before starting the haircut is we prepped the hair with two products that are gonna help with that slip factor. First one was Redken Satin Wear 02. The other benefit of this is that we're going to get a smoother, more polished blow dry, and we're going to get heat protection from it. We layered in two drops of Redken's Diamond Oil. This again is going to help a lot with the slip with the razor. It's also going to give some incredible moisture. So together, they're going to create the perfect palette for razor cutting and an excellent blow dry. We're using an ivory comb. I'm using the short cutting comb, because she has dark hair. I want to use a comb that's always in contrast with the hair color. So if she had light hair, conversely, what I'd do is I'd use a dark comb. My elevation here is going to be 90 degrees horizontal, which basically means that all the grains of the hair are going to be even with the floor. The over direction is forward to the previously cut section. On this first section, I'm just going to over direct forward to where I'm parallel with the front hairline. And that's gonna start to build some length towards the back. We're gonna go fairly short here because we want this to have a really nice tight line through the interior, but we're not gonna go so short that it has more of a sprouty feel. We wanna have something that still lays to the head shape. So we're gonna come in, establish that 90 degrees horizontal, and we're gonna use a circular motion with that straight blade. And you'll notice I'm not sliding away from the head. What I'm doing instead is I'm keeping my fingers locked in place and I'm allowing my fingertips to roll back and away from the head to expose where I need to cut. And that'll establish our guide for length for the rest of the haircut. So every time I take my section, what I do is I just go ahead and slide, and I can even close my eyes and I'll feel right there that guide has slipped through my fingers, and I know I need to just lock in my fingers then and establish and then cut. Again, guys, it's more of a circular motion, and that circular motion, I'm actually kind of following the head shape as I'm working. It's not a perfectly just straight up and down line, I'm working around the head shape. As I continue these diagonal back sections coming into the center back, I'm just gonna mimic my cutting line with the actual head shape. I'm gonna maintain that 90 degree elevation horizontal, and then my cutting line follows the head shape. So I'm just gonna continue working around here into the center back. So we've completed the whole right side. We've stopped at that center back area. Now we need to start again here on our right side. Anytime we're working from front to back, the challenge is that we don't necessarily have a guide to start with. So one of the things we can do is we can come to the front and we can do some measuring. We can establish by measuring. The other option, guys, is since the face has asymmetry to it anyway, we can go in and just create visual balance with our sides. And what I mean by that is picking out reference points and establishing our lengths more based on how it's laying to the facial shape and the head structure, rather than coming in and getting so precise with this exactly matches this. I mean, let's be honest, no one has a perfectly symmetrical face. So if the lengths are exactly the same, it may almost look asymmetric. So again, we're gonna take that diagonal back section, comb that hair out of the way. Again, our elevation is 90 degrees horizontal, meaning flat with the floor. Finger angle mimics the head shape, and over direction is forward to be parallel with that front hairline. Now, I just need to take a peek and see where those lengths are sitting on the other side, and then I'm gonna come through and cut with my razor to establish that same length on the opposite side. Before I go any further, of course, the first thing I wanna do is just step in front of her and just cross-check and make sure I have visual balance. And I'm pretty darn close. So to continue back, all I'm gonna do is the same thing I did on the other side. Take about a half inch of previously cut hair, half inch of new hair, continue my diagonal back sections as I come into that center back. Now, one of the things I want you to take notice of is as we come down into the back area, we are leaving a little bit of length at the bottom, and that's happening because we're keeping that elevation a little on the higher side at 90 degrees horizontal. Had I followed 90 degrees to the head shape and tucked down into the neck, I'm not gonna have that softness around the bottom hairline, which is kind of one of the features of this haircut. So I'm just gonna keep working on this left side, working towards the center back. One of the other things that's gonna happen, since we're starting with guides from the front edge and working towards the back, we're using our over direction forward to build length towards the back. When we get to that center back, we may not match up completely perfectly. Now, if you cross check this in between the two sides and you find that you're a little bit off, let's say you're a little longer here, a little shorter there, don't freak out and go back through and completely redo your haircut. Now, of course, if you're a full inch off on one side or the other, then yes, you wanna go back and readjust. Now, if I come in here and I see that, you know, I just have this little bit of excess length on this side, one of the little things I can do is just come in with my razor and just do a little bit of cross-checking. Just, again, come down on that horizontal, place it into my hand. You can see I've got a little bit of length there. I'm just gonna place right against there and pull. And because we have that guard on the razor, you can do this sort of technique. You can actually do this with a straight-edge razor. It's a little bit scary. And that's just gonna help to balance those sides and make sure we don't end up with too much of a point there in the center. So we don't necessarily want some weird little ducktail back there. So let's start to work on our top sections. So now we're gonna work into our crown detachment area. In some of the other haircuts in this series, you'll hear us talk about the fact that the detachments in haircuts are flipping upside down in fresh haircutting. Now, this is our one haircut in the collection that's more of an undercut, but you'll notice what we're not doing is doing these really tight, close-cropped, shaved-out interiors with huge, long pieces hanging over top. This one's gonna have a different feel to it. And we do feel that undercutting is still an important technique that you understand. It's no longer necessarily a trend in hairdressing, it's actually a technique we use on a regular basis. In this crown area, this is going to be detached longer, sitting over the shorter on the interior. And the way that we're going to do that is we're going to come through and we're going to create pie-shaped or radial sections coming off of the high point of the head. So what we're going to do is we're going to establish a center guideline. So we're going to come from the high point of the head and just create a center parting down the middle. I'm going to comb this over and out of the way. And then we're going to break that piece in half. So again, high point right down through the middle here. So in essence, we're going to keep four separate pieces within this crown area. And take that little piece of the pie and lay it to the side. Now to start this, we're going to switch blades. So instead of using our straight blade, now we're going to actually switch to what we call the 9-gap razor. And the 9-gap acts almost more like a blending shear. So on this blade, you'll notice we've got a small cup and then a small opening. Small cup, small opening, small cup, small opening. So it's going to hold hair out of the way and then allow hair to hit the blade. Again, adding kind of a blending shear type of effect to the work. The elevation again is going to be 90 degrees horizontal, but we're going to change our finger angle quite dramatically here. Our finger angle is going to be a diagonal that creates length towards the top of the head. And the razor technique is going to be more of a horizontal technique now. We're actually using kind of a surface cutting technique. So we come out 90 degrees horizontal. Our over direction is what we're calling a triangular pinch. So what that means is you can see from the outside coming into the center, both sides of this triangle come into the center point. What that does is it creates over direction from the outside of each section. That's going to give us a little bit of a scalloped effect to this section and give a really cool texture to it. Lengthwise, we want to see where we're going to be able to cut and have it sit where we want in the head shape. And what we'd like to see on this is we'd like to see it sit and cup right around the occipital bone. So I think that's going to be about a good length. Establish our length and our finger angle. And then what we're doing is we're coming in more flat, a surface cutting technique. And what this does is it allows us to create a very, very disrupted, really light and airy, movable texture. Now, if I would have done the same thing, but come in with the straight blade and did it traditionally, I wouldn't have nearly as disruptive of a texture as I do from doing more of that surface technique with the 9-gap razor. To go to our next section, what we need to do is just take a little piece off the edge of our previously cut section. We don't want to take too much, because if we take too much, we're actually going to over-direct the middle of that section, which is slightly shorter, into our new section, and that'll give us a false guide. Same thing on this next section. We're going to use that triangular pinch technique. So the outsides of the section are brought into the center so that we create that scalloped look to the outside. Elevation 90 degrees horizontal, which means flat with the floor. And again, we're going to come in, establish our finger angle, which is diagonal, creating length towards the top, and surface cut coming up towards the top. And you'll see that same sort of circular motion with the razor that we employed on the underneath. Now, what we should see when we take this cross section is we should see a lot of movement in our line. We should see kind of peaks and valleys happening. So we'll see length, short, length, short, length. And that's again from that over direction, from the outsides into the middle of it. To continue, we're gonna use that exact same technique of picking up a small piece from the outside, using that as our guide for the outside edge of that next triangle, and then using our triangular pinch. We're gonna do that through the next two sections here. All right, this crown area is fully completed. And as you can see, it just gives us a really nice texture veil that lays over top of our underneath. Now, just a few things about this crown area with your sections. I had four even sections. The wider your sections are, the more of that kind of scalloped effect that you're going to have. So could I have done this in three sections? Yes, absolutely. I would have had a little bit more of that wave and that texture to it. Could I have even reduced it down to two sections? 100%, yes, you can. And depending on the size of the client's head, the surface area you're working on, you're gonna have to adapt that section size to suit those elements and your desired texture. The front area is going to work really similarly to how we worked the crown. We're gonna, again, start with a center parting from the high point to the forehead. Now, I'm gonna as is something, because some of you may notice that the parting on the top of the head changed. When I initially set up my parting, I put in a section right above the left eye. As I was working through my crown, I realized I actually don't need that because I'm starting from a center section. So yes, I'm human too, I apologize. So now we're just taking that whole top section and we're going to put in our center part, which is what we needed. Again, we're just gonna isolate that extra hair off to the side for a moment, and then we're gonna come here, come to the high point, and break that quadrant into two pieces as well. Now with this one, the big change is our elevation. Instead of elevation being 90 degrees horizontal, now we're going to go to 90 degrees vertical, which means straight up and down or parallel with the walls. This is going to give us a much softer effect, and it's also going to give us the ability to go shorter from the crown to even longer towards that outside edge than doing the 90 degrees horizontal. Now, how long do I want that crown area? We're going to pick up a piece from our previously cut area in the back and use that as our guide for our shortest point there at the high point. I'm gonna switch razors one more time. Now on this one, we're gonna go with the 6-gap razor. The difference with the 6-gap razor is now we have larger areas of exposure and larger cups to hold the hair back and out of the way. This is gonna give us a much deeper texture effect. So this is gonna give that front a really nice, airy, very disrupted texture. The over direction is just as we did in the back. Those outsides of the triangle are coming into the center, resulting in a triangular pinch, which allows extra length to be established towards the outsides, and then a shorter area on the inside. I'm choosing a diagonal finger angle that's going to build length towards the front of the head, and again, I'm coming in more of a surface cutting motion with that 6-gap razor. And you'll notice how quickly the hair kind of falls away because there is so much more exposed surface with that 6-gap. Just as we did in the back, we're gonna take a small piece of our previously cut triangle as a guide for length for our next one. Again, elevation is 90 degrees vertical, straight up towards that ceiling. And the over direction is that triangular pinch where the outside edges of the section are gonna meet in the center. Establish our finger angle, short to long towards the outside, and then come in with that surface cutting technique with the 6-gap razor. We're gonna use this exact same technique as we rotate through the next two areas. As you can see, once you're completed with that fringe area, you have quite a bit of excess length. Now, 9 times out of 10, you're probably not gonna be doing this haircut starting from such a fresh long head of hair as we have here. Your guest may have previously cut fringe. They probably even have a shorter haircut to begin with. So you're not usually gonna be left with this much excess length. Now, it could happen though where you are starting out with a lot of length through there, and we need to adjust that. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna do a simple flat wrap technique to get her into natural fall, just nice and polished, a really natural finish, and then we're gonna address this excess length. So I'm just going to set up, work a comb technique through the fringe to make sure that I polish off any kind of crazy growth patterns that can happen there, because that comb's gonna give me a little extra tension. The rest is gonna be done with the paddle brush and then finished with our styling brush. Now that we've completed our blow dry process, we've got a nice finished product here to do our refinements on. As you can see, we still have a lot of this length left over because we started with that doll head that had so much length in the front. So let's refine some of that, because even though your guest might not have that much excess length, there probably will be some stuff down here that you want to refine. One of my favorite tools for doing this is our Signature Series blending shear. And the reason for this is I use this in a way similar to what I would use a regular pair of shears, except now I'm using it to add more softness and more texture. So this is our very visual aspect. We're gonna come in and we're really just gonna come in and use that blending shear again, like we would use a regular shear. We're gonna do an open and close as we come down through. And that's gonna just take away that length and leave us with a really soft edge. It's gonna more closely match the razor texture than if I came in and did with this with a regular shear. The other thing that we notice is when we do this kind of technique in the salon, and it's something new and different for our clients, they actually take notice to it and they get excited about it. Like, hey, you've never actually done this exact technique on my hair, what are you doing? And then we can explain to them, well, I saw this done in a video, this really cool guy taught me this technique. And they know then we're learning and progressing as a hairdresser, which we actually know is one of the main reasons that people leave their hairdressers, because they feel like they're not progressing and they're not changing in their craft. So you can see that gives me a really cool texture, very loose, very razored. And this is starting to become something a little bit more realistic as an in-salon haircut. Same thing, we're gonna step to this side now, to her right side. Our part for this haircut is actually a little more over the right eye after everything's divided up. And really that was established by just blow drying that hairline into natural fall and seeing where it wanted to go. A lot of times we force a part into the haircut and we're not able to have our guests replicate that at home because it's not where their hair naturally wants to part. Another area of refinement that we'll want to address is this hairline. And again, I love using the reversible blending shear to do my refinement because it's gonna maintain that razored texture and a nice softness. I can come through and also use it to remove weight where I wanna remove weight. So to finish this off, we're gonna use just a little bit of Redken's Rough Paste 12. The reason I'm gonna use this is I actually wanna put a little bit more texture into the hair. And the rough paste is nice because I can get some tackiness and some movement, but it's not gonna be overly aggressive as long as I don't go crazy with it. So I'm just gonna use a little like toothpaste size. I'm gonna work it into my hands first, make sure it's really well distributed all over my hands, almost like I'm washing my hands with it. And then I'm gonna come in from the inside and work it from the inside out, making sure that I get it down at the scalp to create some structure at the base. And in there, as I'm working this hair over the top, you can see that degree of shortness on the interior of our undercut. So I'm sure a lot of you get the reference, Layla being a very popular song. And so we want to impart a bit of that rock and roll into the finish of the haircut as well. This is a fun technique on clients because it allows them a lot of different personalities with their haircut. They can style this in so many different ways. They can style it very polished, like it was after we finished the blow dry. They can follow it up with the rough paste, add more dimension and texture to it, and have a lot more rock and roll. So let's review our steps. First thing we want to do is we want to create our high side of our tilted shape. So we're going to come from the recession area, and we're going to create a curved diagonal back section all the way back here to the right corner back. On the left side, what's going to create our tilt and a little more weight to this side is we're actually coming more from the temple area to create that same curved diagonal back line to the corner back. After we establish those two points, we're then going to come from the high point and create a nice little circle that connects to that corner back and then comes around the low crown and connects again to our corner back on our right side. That's going to give us our little circle here in the crown. Once we've established those two partings, we're going to clip them up cleanly out of the way so that we can work on our underneath. The underneath is cut with our straight blade razor. And the reason we're doing that is we want to really be able to cleanly remove that excess length. So we're using diagonal back sections, about 1 inch diagonal back sections, over direction forward to the previously cut section. Our finger angle is following the head shape while our elevation stays 90 degrees horizontal, which means it's flat with the floor. That will help us maintain a bit of that length around the perimeter and give it a softer feel around the neckline so it's not so shaved in. We're going to continue that all the way around to the center back, and then we'll continue by establishing the same guide on her left side and again working around the center back, meeting in that center point. And remember, guys, if you get to the back and it's not completely perfect in the center back, just take those horizontal sections and cross-check yourself. If you're way off, of course, you want to go back and readjust the overall haircut. The crown is where the real fun begins now, because we switch to that 9-gap razor, we establish a center parting down the back, and we divide that parting into two equal pieces. So we basically have two little pie-shaped sections there. We're going to collect all that hair into the center. We're over-directing the outsides into the center, creating a triangular pinch, which creates that little bit of scalloping on the outside edge. Again, our elevation is 90 degrees horizontal, but now our finger angle is on a diagonal, creating graduation, getting longer towards the top of the section. We use just a little piece of that to move into our next sections as our guide, and we continue with those big triangles over-directing to the center for our triangular pinch. Moving into the fringe area, it's essentially the same thing. The main thing that's changing now is our elevation. Now, instead of doing a 90 degrees horizontal elevation, we're going into 90 degree vertical elevation. Our finger angle is such that we'll go from shortest at the high point to longest at the perimeter edge around the front hairline. We're again going to use just a little piece of the previously cut section as our guide for the length for the next section and work all the way around to the left side. What's really cool about this haircut, guys, again, is the multiple personalities you can get from it. And what's awesome with undercuts especially is you have these peekaboo elements. So she can come back, she can take this length and she can tuck it back, and all of a sudden she exposes that shortness underneath. So she really can do so many different things with this haircut. It's cut in a way where the textures can fall in many different places, so the part can change, the texture can change. We could even blow dry this back and give her a really cool pompadour effect. So thanks for watching. We really hope you enjoyed the Layla haircut. There's more to come. Watch out for our Modern Heritage Collection. I'm Andrew Carruthers, Education Director for Sambia.